In the epic poem Song of Myself in Walt Whitman's Leaves of Grass, Whitman's speaker introduces himself to the world and celebrates himself in this, arguably the most renowned manifesto of his poetic vision. Broken into 52 sections, he begins by observing a spear of summer grass. Despite all the perfume that surrounds him, he breathes in the fragrance of himself and describes what nature means to him and poems. The speaker, the audience, nature, the nation, all are a flowing collective consciousness. The speaker tells of how the people of the nation affect him and how he accepts each and every one of them, no matter who they are, listing the multitudes of diverse people as well as anecdotes about them. The list includes a catalog of people going about their daily business across the country, as well as animals and places in nature. And anecdotes are varied too. Some are intimate, like the tale in section 10 of the runaway slave that the speaker takes in and cares for. Some are generally historical, such as the tale of a Revolutionary War sea battle in section 35. Near the end of the poem, after describing his poetic vision, this speaker, who contains multitudes, offers an invitation. Who wishes to walk with me? Will you speak before I am gone? As if pausing to wait for an answer, he then declares, I sound my barbaric yawp over the roofs of the world. Song of Myself is a very long, very famous celebration of the all-encompassing persona that Walt Whitman creates in Leaves of Grass, a strong representation of his unconventional, democratic brand of poetry. In the first edition, this poem is not divided into numbered sections, and it ends with the word you, which meant to allow the reader to circle back endlessly to the beginning I of the poem, a symbolic joining of Whitman's speaker with his audience into a collective entity, a circuit not unlike the cycle of life itself. As he says in section 3, I do not talk of the beginning or the end. His poetry is timeless, will never be any more perfection than there is now. Whitman published the first edition of Leaves of Grass anonymously, but the attentive reader will notice that he states his name and introduces himself midway through this first poem in section 24. Walt Whitman, an American, one of the roughs, a cosmos. He is a poet of a democratic American people, containing them, speaking for his people, because he knows them omnisciently, as he says in section 1, for every atom belonging to me, as good belongs to you. This is part of his unifying message. People are like leaves of grass. They are individual spears, but they make up a collective whole. What is the grass? A child asks in section 6. And in section 31, Whitman's speaker answers, I believe a leaf of grass is no less than the journey work of the stars. As the speaker claims in section 44, he is stripping away what is known and launching all men and women forward with me into the unknown. The unknown includes free verse, Whitman's major innovation in poetry, which he introduces with this rambling, epic journey of a poem.